Who is Speck on this thing? Who needs fire prevention anyway? Expert loader was good, even though someone said it's not good. Did we just give up fire prevention? Yeah. Fire prevention is for noobs. AFT is useless. Why do you need IFHE? Because these things don't pen shit without IFHE. There we go. My priority target? Because when you fight BD's cruisers or other Tirpitzes, it tells you when they're torping. Using expert load is a waste if you ask me. You basically always use HE except for cruisers. No. I fucking blepped that Massachusetts for like 40k AP. Recently got the Kremlin, should I get Kuznetsov or some other tier 9, 10 ship for coal? I mean, that depends. Do you like the Kremlin? Are you gonna play the Kremlin a lot? If you are, then Kuznetsov is pretty fucking good. But if you're not planning on playing it like a madman, then the ship would obviously be more valuable.
Thank you.
What the fuck? Where did those shills go, chat? What the fuck was that? Where the fuck did those shells go? IFHE not impressive versus Massachusetts? What do you mean? IFHE was the reason I won this fight. IFHE fucking shredded him? Look, let me show you boys something. Yeah. That was my main guns, that was my secondaries. That's why you fucking ran IFHE. Let me teach you a lesson here, boys. That's what you fought. There's his secondary damage. Let's look at his secondary damage. 13k with 152 hits. 176 hits, 42,000. I have itchy fucking shreds. Because it gives these guns that have a 2.9 second reload, they give a 33mm pen. Which means no battleship can tank you. If they try to run away like that guy did, Tirpitz is fast enough to keep track, keep chasing it, and then the second is just shred. Everyone is playing Massachusetts on MA. Everyone is, I swear, everyone plays Massachusetts on this server. I still don't know if Massachusetts can shred this thing, or if these guys have just played really potato. What 3-point skill are you using? BFT. Faster reload on secondaries. I think Massachusetts can do a lot of work on a Tirpitz, mostly because the guns are better and the secondary raw, like the raw amount of shells you throw out, is better. I've gotten really shitty edge heroism.
The ship is on fire. Thank you.
solved, sir.
I don't know what this guy thought would happen. What was the plan here? I don't understand. You're gonna drive by a Tirpitz? Is he a potato? Maybe he just got the Massachusetts or something. That would make sense. Ah. The NA server is, yeah, I'm not gonna say anything. The NA server is unique. The NA server is different. Winner of Cults, that's true. Who am I to speak? They won Cults. What have I won? Not Cults, that's for sure. Oh shit. Interesting. Tirpitz will have the highest win rate of BBs in this event. I don't know. It can't do shit against the DD. I mean, that guy might have also just been, it's a Tirpitz, I can't do shit, who gives a shit, let's just go for it. But I don't know why he wouldn't go for the ram if that was the case. That didn't look like a ram attempt. That was, I don't get it. Could just have turned and started kiting. Yeah, I mean, that was if he was trying. If he wasn't trying, if he just wanted to end it fast, why not try to go for ram? But that literally looked like he was trying to do a drive-by and... I don't know. Very questionable. Well played, Bismarck, and I think absolutely shit on me in this game mode. I don't see why you couldn't. I got my torp tubes. That's unfortunate. That was really lucky because he wasn't even shooting HE to target and he just lucked out. guy doing? I can't shoot my broads then. I'm just gonna slow down here.
The ship is on
fire. You got my torp too, so he should have gone for the brawl with, I don't know. You got really lucky. His secondaries clipped my torp tubes. I don't think it was even his main guns. It was secondaries he clipped. Like, if you fight Bismarck versus Tirpitz, you want to shoot HE at the start, and you want to target the back of the ship over here. Because if you manage to break the torp tubes, then it's a very even battle. Like, it's a really even battle if you manage to clip the torp tubes. Because torp tubes on the Tirpitz are really fucking vulnerable. So all you need to do is hit this general area and they tend to break. So I don't know why he didn't do anything then. NC. That's a rough matchup for the NC. So many BBs. This, you can tell we switched from Russia to NA. On Russia it was a shit ton of DDs, like le terrible all the time. The occasional carriers and cruisers. Here it's nothing but BB spam. I haven't faced any ship besides a battleship so far. Tirpitz is really good against battleships, pretty damn good against cruisers as well. Actually really good against cruisers, I'd say. But kind of shit against DDs because of no real hydro, and the torpedo belt is pretty questionable, and it's a pretty easy ship to farm. On the other hand, it does have secondaries to kind of compensate, but not really that good. Oh, did Jingles answer my mail? Jingles! You're fucking watching the stream. Check your Discord, you potato. When are we playing Get the Fuck Out? He sits there watching my stream, ignoring Discord. What a dude. Thank you, King Louis, for the prime sub. He's gonna go for it now. Maybe. But I'm already in secondary range, so. And I mean, now we just kite, well. And as long as I have torpedoes ready, he has to be afraid of me potentially torping him.
Main turret critically damaged!
I'm also much faster than he is, so... Where are you going, dude? You know what? Let's drop you some candies. Have at them, champ. Nom 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 nom. Jingle's answer. Fucking straight up ignoring me. What a dude. Nothing but BBs, man. It's insane. Nothing but BBs. DD Mafia Cruiser Cartel. Yeah, what is it? Battleship? All cruisers are on you. Massachusetts? I'd rather not. Honestly, Massachusetts... You kind of have to kite away all the time. You can't. You don't want to push in and brawl, you want to kite away. Battleship Brotherhood? Ooh. The BB Ranked? BB Cultists? You go IFHM Massachusetts. What pen did you reach on that thing? Probably. ?27 with IFHE? Then I would go IFHE. Wait, what the fuck? Why are you back there? What the fuck? Why are you so far away? Are you snoozing back? This isn't a random battle where you can sit in the back and snipe. That's not how you fucking play. Speed or something? I don't get up.
The ship is on fire.
I just get within secondary range. Let me see how much secondary damage I can do to this guy. Totally ram us and maybe get a trade here, but I want to see how much I can do. Just secondary farming. Because this is an Amagi, so he's got 32mm plating. And don't give me broadside, I can't resist it that I want you if you do. Actually, at this range, I probably can. You're so close. Smart. Turn away? why. This AP isn't doing shit. Thank God for the secondaries. We'd be losing hard without them. He's secondary Amagi as well, I think. I guess no one told him that secondary Amagi is actually pretty trash. Let's put a plane up. And wait, my secondaries I think can shoot or the island while I'm undetected. Yeah, look at that. Come on. Aw, oh, come on. Oh, he's just gonna cook to a nice crisp or that. Not sure what they hoped would happen. I'm not sure what his plan was, but I don't think it worked very well. Our victory is in sight. Let's see the secondary damage, boys. It's gonna be something juicy. What? Really? Oh, fuck me. I thought it was gonna be more than that. That's pretty sad. Pay hands. Oh, shit. Lightning. A DD, finally not a BB. Now we should get wrecked, right? It was like less than 3 minutes of fight, that's true. So, wait, I should probably edit title. When was his rank? DD Mafia coming to collect. In bandage room. Someone brought an Edinburgh to ranked, it was odd. I don't know, Radar Edinburgh I think could do pretty well. YOLO potential against battleships, can probably trade well against cruisers, Radar and Hydro Shreds DDs. It was a smoke Edinburgh. Ah, okay, well then I'm less convinced. He just entered the camp. So he's right here, sitting like this.
Spotter airborne.
Oh shit, you're YOLO? That's a bold move. Ballsy move, my friend. Ballsy doesn't always mean smart, though. You're aware of this, right?
Black Robin,
ambitious YOLO. Straight through the open water in a direct line towards me. That was ambitious. I will call it ambitious. Optimistic, perhaps? optimistic as well. Ambitious and optimistic. When I said spicy matchup, I did not have this in mind. Ambitions mixed up with his capabilities. Yeah, I guess. Chat. 187 followers to 93k. Oh, baby. Soon 93k followers. Then we only need to grind 7k for the big 100k giveaway. That's crazy. The grind has been insane for both your channels. Yeah, I need to post a YouTube bit again though. My girlfriend isn't coming over tonight. So tonight I'll post a bit. I've been taking a bit of a Christmas holiday from the YouTube channel, so I haven't posted any vids in a bit. But we need to start posting again. We need to start posting again. We're at 82,000 subs on YouTube. Nice. We need to keep grinding that as well. Interesting, I'm a broadside. And his HP perk. Hmm. 12k through the nose. That's interesting. Can we get the cap? We might be able to get the cap before he can spot us. I mean, if you're gonna let me just camp here in peace, I don't mind. This is gonna hurt. But we'll get the camp right after, so it's fine. Turn in and eat my torpedoes, please. Yes, he just wants to give me broadside. Who am I to judge? Are you gonna turn out? Then I will absolutely stop here in camp.
Main turret critically damaged.
He stopped behind the island. Wow. What an epic outplay.
Our victory is in sight.
That's some sick outplay you're doing there, NC. Whatever will I do when you're letting me heal while I'm holding a 2-cap advantage against you. Whatever will I do? Big downside for me here.
Our team has taken the lead.
And now he's pushing. I can't believe I can't sit at all this game. Makes me so sad. Very few fires as well. I can't believe I didn't get a single citadel on that guy. He gave me so much broadside. This fire damage was so underwhelming as well, holy shit. Oh well. IFHE came through. Oh shit. A curious Flamu, on 1-to-1 ranked, why pick the skill that shows tells you how many people are shooting at you? Because it also tells you if someone switched to torpedoes. This, the priority target skill, tells you how many ships are pointing their main battery guns at you. Well, if you switch to your torpedoes, well, you're no longer aiming your main battery guns, are you? No, you're aiming your torpedoes. So what it tells you is that the guy you're fighting just switched to his torpedoes and he's right now torping you. So it's in fact incredibly useful in a 1v1 situation. The perk especially says that shows you how many players are aiming their main battery guns at you. Anything that's not main battery is torpedoes. So when you're fighting a DD and suddenly the number one disappears, well, you know exactly what he just did. And that's when it's time to change course or speed. Or if you're fighting a cruiser or you're fighting a Tirpitz or whatever, you know exactly when he's lining up torps. Is he selling this one? See, I don't mind closing the distance.
Just joined the stream. Are CVs as broken in 1v1 as everyone thought?
It depends on... You get a pretty good chance of just out-capping them. Oh, fuck off. Might lose the torpedo too. the torpedo.
Destroyed. Yeah.
Just set a perma fire on him.
The ship is on fire.
That's a second perma fire. Last bet of winning was ramming me, but he's not going for it, so whatever. This thing is hard to beat with this build. Yeah, it's a good, it's the same build I ran on test server with when I tried 1v1. The Germans are insanely good in rank, like the cruisers, Hipper Eugen and Bismarck Tirpitz, they're all really fucking good. No more Lo Yang? Well, I ranked out with Lo Yang on Russia. I already ranked out on Russia, so that was enough Lo Yang for a while. So, I have Lo Yang on NA, but I can't be honest. What do you think of that Dago? It's got too many weaknesses. RFM for the BDs. Yep. And occasional sneaky cruiser. Is this with IFHE? Yes. Fuck, I switched too soon. Oops. Aww. I don't want to turn left yet, because if I can keep this island between me and him, I can get the cap. Which means if I cut away this way and we trade and fight, this cap is taking points for me the entire time. I don't understand why they keep giving me this cap advantage. They're giving me an advantage for future fights for no reason. There's no reason. Again. I think he's that scared to sit out because of that. We're gonna give a lot of broadside here, but it's fine because we should be able to citadel him. Right, Tirpitz! Okay, never mind.
Main turret critically damaged!
Obviously, the environment down here is all salt. The ceiling's salt, the floor's salt, the walls are salt. and to an extent, the air is soft.
Congrats on another successful year, Flamu. Could you tell us what you would be doing as a career if you weren't streaming? Wishing you more success in 2020.
Something computer related and nerdy, if I wasn't streaming. I can tell you that much. I'm also, surprisingly, something that's actually come from streaming is the ability to speak to in front of crowds and in public, just to a lot of people. That's something that's come entirely from streaming. Telemarketing. Poor dude. That's kind of fucking filthy. You pen the deck armor of that ship as well, because you get more than 38 on the big guns when you run IFHing. When showing us the setup? Sure. Remind me after this game, I'll show you the build. That's great. I've always had trouble speaking to audiences. Yeah, I mean, I think it comes from the fact that, well, just doing casting, a lot of casting, like with Wargaming, and then just talking with the webcam, having webcam on, and just in general talking to you guys. Like right now it's 2.6k people there. When I started streaming, talking to this many people at once would have gotten me nervous as all hell. Like, holy shit, I would have been so nervous, jittery, shaky, like, what the fuck, what do I do? This is far too many people for one potato. So, it has helped a lot. Just constantly talking to you guys has helped. When you talk, when you every day you talk to thousands of people, it's kind of hard to get nervous when you're talking to, like, 50 people in real life. It's like, well, hello there. Get more confident when you realize we are all idiots. Yeah, no, I'm an idiot as well, so. I'm like, hey, they're my kin. Back when Flolo actually goes full ham while streaming and didn't even dare to eat in front. Yeah, I mean, I was nervous to like have food breaks and shit during streaming. I was like, well, I can't do that. That's not cool. So I just stream like 6 hours and then I'd be fucking starving from hunger. Jesus, that Tirpitz is broken. Fire on the first hit. Well, that's pretty strong. Back when you were a professional streamer, not eating on stream, right? Back in the golden days. Double fire.
Alright!
Reinforce the damage con this early is not cool.
Thunderer or Salem? I don't have DM and don't like BBs that much. Is Thunderer too good to pass up?
Kinda. It's pretty fucking insane.
Problem solved, sir. The ship is on fire.
Another double fire. Question is, how is it gonna deal with this island? Is it gonna turn out? I think he has to turn out.
Torpedo tubes destroyed.
Well, that sucks. But I should be able to equalize it around this island. Okay. Never mind. Why can't I sit at all that time? I set two fires on him before I wanted to cover it though, so. His fields heal repair a lot faster than mine. So I need to do some fucking damage to him ASAP before. Because if this becomes a sustained battle, he will eventually out-sustain me. For every heal I use, he can use two heals. That's how fast Massachusetts heal regrows. I get some insane fire chance now.
The ship is on fire.
Turn the fire shields. Can't, if you allow a Massachusetts to just sit there behind the island, he's gonna recover so much fucking health. Thunder or Salem? I don't have DM and I don't like BBs that much. Is Thunder too good to pass up? It kinda is really fucking good. So, skipping it is questionable. As for Salem, it's not really that special of a ship. Salem is kind of questionable. Oh shit, the build! Fuck! I have the memory of a goldfish. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I know. I have the memory of a goldfish. I apologize. Magnus did a lot wrong.
Nice to see a game mode that Germany excels in.
Alright. Flamu asked us to remind him, right? Why didn't you remind me, Chan? Ever faced something else than BB on NA? I faced the lightning, who decided to YOLO me through the open water. It did not end very well for him. Is this guy really going through here? Jeez, he is. Okay. Not sure why, but okay.
The ship is on fire.
You got a double fire in the first hit. That's some RNG. Wait for one more shot from him. Actually, he's turning, so we're gonna turn as well.
Problem solved, sir.
I just wanna be in second range. What your plan is, buddy, but like, are you gonna try to out secondary me in my Tirpitz? That's your plan. Your plan is to out secondary me in my Tirpitz in your gas can. Or are you just gonna rush me and ram me? Because that's what I thought you were gonna do. Wait, no, you cancelled it? You didn't go for the ram? What?
Main turret critically damaged! The ship is on fire!
Well? Would have not been a bad idea, but.
Problem solved, sir.
Are you grounded? Show your build. Sometimes you should let them live longer and see what they do. That's what I was doing there. I stopped shooting to see what his plan was. How are we doing on NA? Yeah, that's kind of what I thought. Questionable. Right, build wise. Spotter plane to see behind the islands and shit. Upgrade wise, secondary survival. Yeah, you lose turrets, you lose torpedo tubes a shit ton, but who gives a shit? Your secondaries are doing work anyway. Tankiness, secondary, faster rudder shift, and proximity spotting. Fires are not likely to be the reason you die. Captain build wise, priority target. To see if people are switching to torps. You want to know when people are torping you, and this tells you. It shows a 1 when they target you with main guns, but then when they switch to torpedoes, the number 1 disappears. So you know exactly when someone torps you if you run this skill. Expert loader, because you switch between HE and AP all the time. AR, BFT for better secondaries, RPF to see where they are, manual secondaries to actually make your secondaries useful, and IFHE. Proximity spotting? Yes, because concealment is completely useless in value. The second they shoot, you spot them anyway, so who gives a shit? Whereas this thing will give you 3km spotting on DDs you push into, as well as helping you spot torpedoes, which is much more useful. This is the one game mode where I will always recommend target or concealment, unless you're a DD or a cruiser, and when it can be different. No AFT? No? Because you're gonna be pushing into that 9.4km secondary range instantly anyway, so what's the point? So, yeah, this is my 1 versus 1 build. Thank you, Doug Danger, for the sub. Would Roma be good for 1 versus 1? No. Dreadful. No fire prevention? No. Isn't fighter better? Sure, but the range is extremely small on the fighter. Which DD do you think will do good? A kid? Loyang, at least. I ranked out on Russia earlier today with Loyang. I literally ranked out today, like, in the first couple of hours, I ranked out on Russia. I took down a couple of CVs as well in the Loyang. You don't need to kill them, you just smoke up and sit in the cap, that's all you need to do. And you win on points. How come you think the kid is good? It can 1 versus 1 pretty much any DD thanks to the heal and the gun power. It's got enough torpedo power to take down cruisers, and if you soften up the battleships with your guns first, you can torp them to death. Or just farm them to death. And it does well against carriers because it can just outcap the carriers.
Hey ya Flolo, hey ya chat.
The ship is on fire.
Yeah, he's going for the cap tactic. That's interesting, not a bad move.
Problem solved, sir.
Oh fuck, I switched too soon again. That's potato. Thank you, Joseph Bones, thank you for the sub, Ruthless, thank you for the 11.
Spotter airborne.
Still contesting it, which means I should be able to catch his broadside here. I think he's gonna turn this one. Oh no, he came through here. We're gonna slow down. Mm-hmm. committing now. Now we run away.
The ship is on fire.
Funny little game where I did more damage than my secondaries. Nos V8, thank you for the 11. How's the build bot doing? Oh shit, what happened to the build bot on my Discord that we were supposed to get? Wonder what happened with that. Flamu already ranked 1 in Russia? Yeah, I ranked out earlier today. The good part about 1 vs 1 is there's no shitty teammates. There's only one shit teammate. Are you playing Get the Fuck Out with Jingles today? I don't think so. He hasn't responded today on Discord. Let's see, has he responded? No, what a slacker. So probably not anything today. These games have showed how useless the torpedo tubes often are, and why Bismarck does really well. And I don't agree with people who say Tirpitz is better than Bismarck, because Tirpitz torpedo tubes get knocked out all the time. Like, all the fucking time they just break. Whereas Bismarck's Hydro is always effective. Did that break this torp tube? No one knows. But such is the life of Tirpitz. There we go. Torpedo tubes destroyed. That took really long, John.
Torpedo tubes destroyed!
Oh, it broke both sides. No torps. No torps. That's a lot of damage. As I said, torp tubes are a joke. They're a decoration. Oh shit. Oh shit, this is gonna be scary as fuck. Textbook example. Oh fuck, it's this map as well. The first time I get this map and it's against the DD. Yeah. I'm fucked. I'm hella fucked. I'm hella fucked. This map is so bad for any sort of build that needs range. I think we just got the RNG to death, boys. Fuck, do we do this? This is the only open water. If you come in from here, we've got some open water to play with. If we go for this narrow passage, there's no open water, and it's guaranteed death. Oh, I had an AP loaded. Whoops. Load sap creed guy? I wish. Not a bad idea, bunny. He actually saw me. Well, he knows my plan now. Oh shit, he's playing bad aggro?
Spotter airborne.
Spotter plane should come around just as we cross here. Come on, spotter plane. Give me that information. Oh, I used torps. But use them all? That's hella questionable. Doesn't he only have 2 cents?
Torpedoes to port. Torpedo tubes destroyed. Problem solved, sir.
Not being torqued by dispersion? I think I am. Whoa, what? Look at my secondaries. Where are they shooting? That's pretty rough. Need a couple of hits, secondaries. You should be done. I don't know what he did. I literally do not know. He forget to smoke. He doesn't have a smoke. He's French. He got really lucky with that first torpedo not having any gap for me. And for some reason my secondaries landed all around him. I don't know why my secondaries were so shit. Normally secondaries are really good, but secondaries decided to land all around him. Grounding makes aim wonky. Yeah, I'd hope the secondaries at least would have had somewhat decent aim, but the secondaries also kept whiffing.
Action stations. Mm.
This wind is flooding only last 30 seconds since like a long time ago. Closing in on 93k followers, champ. 100k followers? Do you think we can get it in January, maybe? That would be a juicy fucking giveaway. I'm gonna aim to try to get the 100k before January. I'm gonna have to sell out a bit to get people to press follow the channel. But if you can hit that 100k followers, goddamn, we can do a big giveaway. What torps were you using in Russia? The short range, of course. The long range torps are complete trash on the Loyang. You can't use them for 1v1 at all. Before it goes down, maybe break his torp tips.
Spotter airborne.
Of course I switch to HE and it gives me a flat board then. Classic.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck. I have 30. I can't overmatch 27mm plate and which is what the Baltimore has. So I guess. I mean, can he even draw if he rams me? I mean, he can kill himself. Do I have ramming flag? I don't have ramming flag, so I guess if he pulls off a ram, he can draw. I use manual secondaries? Yes. Ramming flag might cost me. I don't think I have it. I should really have it for rank though, because it's actually kind of a must-have flag. The one with more points wins in a ram scenario. Yeah, but the start points are if neither can get the cap. Let's load AP. See if he angles or some shit. Instead of Bismarck? I don't have a Bismarck, and I haven't played Tirpitz in ages. It's fun. I think they're pretty equal in terms of effectiveness. Tirpitz is better against BBs. Bismarck is better against DDs. It early because it goes clockwise. So I needed to go make a full turn. No, it goes counterclockwise. Shit, I didn't run. Well, I think it should be fine. If he's got AA on, he's gonna get spotted. Baltimore is pretty goddamn stealthy though. Baltimore ranked this like, if it doesn't get a ram off, I don't really, there's no real threat. Torpedo tubes managed to get destroyed, of course. They're literally a decoration on the Tirpitz. People who rate them as anything are like idiots, because they're literally a decoration that just breaks all the time. Ryder, thank you for the sub. Flamu should do a speed run of this. See how fast he can rank out in real time. Yeah. Flamu GG's. Wait, what? Drill, are you playing Baltimore in ranked? Was that you? Tell me it wasn't you, buddy. Why do you hate yourself? Bye. Using the back guns until I get into the objective. Not using back guns until my secondaries are chiming in. Only Tirpitz, nothing else. Well, I thought I'd use Tirpitz until I lose again. But like, I'm still waiting. Normally you shouldn't throw away torps like this, but Alabama is actually really slow and Tirpitz is really fast, so he's got no chance of catching me if I kite. So I'm not afraid of him being able to ram me, because I can reach it to just run to the edge of the map. I was trying to give you a compliment. Ah, okay. Sorry, I thought you were the guy playing the Baltimore. Thank you then. I'm sorry, but it came. I took it the. I thought you were making life very difficult. I thought you were like challenging yourself for something very, very difficult. Why are you giving so much broadside? I feel bad shooting HE when you give this much broadside. You realize that? I feel like a potato when you give this much broadside and I'm shooting HE. Oh well. At least you're cooking nicely. Jesus, that's a bonfire nap. For 4th upgrade, you use torpedo. TA or concealment? Is that target proximity spotting thing? What is it called? I mean, obviously not concealment. Concealment is useless. No tubes destroyed. What is it called? It's called. TASM, target acquisition. Oh yeah, that's what it's called. Yeah, no, this is what... Concealment is useless, this one versus one. Well done, Burger. Okay. This is stupid. I was like, I'll play until I lose. But then it's just dumb. Let me do a giveaway in between. I need to go by the toilet.